you can sneak away.
Welcome to the Mike Less Farmhand Mike YouTube channel. A farming and outdoor channel that I started in 2012 that now has over 1,600 videos and thanks to you has over 180,000 subscribers with 100 plus million total views and over 12 million hours of total watch time. I am filming and uploading new content all the time, so come along for the ride. It's wheat harvest time in Colorado, and I am back out at Byers at a family farm that runs 12 Lexion Combines. Good chance if you've been following my YouTube channel for a few years, you've seen some videos from this farm from years past. I missed the last two summers, so it's great to be back here, and this year they got 12 brand new Claas Lexion 7500 Combines, and this year they are running the Claas 1230 Convio draper heads that are 40 foot wide. And running beside the combines, they are running three of their Case International 500 four-wheel drive tractors pulling Demco grain carts. Once these guys are out in the field running, it's virtually impossible to try to get a picture of all 12 combines running together. However, they have 11 of them lined up here at the beginning of the day, so this is the best I'm going to be able to do throughout this long video. A couple farmers I know from Indiana come out here every year and run some combines for this farm. That's who got me in touch with these guys years ago. This farm is based out of Byers, Colorado. However, the field we were in this video was up closer to Fort Morgan, Colorado. The farming practices in this area are a lot different than what you see in a lot of my other farming YouTube videos. Byers, Colorado sets east of Denver at 5,210 feet elevation. This area is a very dry climate. They may only get about 15 inches of rain a year here, maybe 45 inches of snow. This area gets about 249 sunny days every year, and a lot of this ground you see here is only farmed every other year. This field of winter wheat that they just harvested right here was planted last fall, and this field will set fallow all through next summer, so next year this will not have a crop on it. This farm grows mostly wheat and some milo. And this year they had about 7,000 acres of wheat that got hailed out, so it's 7,000 less that they will be harvesting. Farmland out here is going to be a lot less expensive than it is in the Midwest, just due to the dry climate, the yields they get. A lot of this wheat out here is 30, 35 bushel an acre wheat, but they got a lot of acres. There is a little bit of irrigation out here in some areas where they do grow corn and alfalfa. At night when they finish harvesting, they line all the machines up like you see here, so the next morning they can come through, fuel them, service them, and get ready to cut for another day. As you can see, the fields out here are huge in size, a lot of rolling prairie out here. I have a lot of good drone shots, some on-the-ground shots. I also do an in-cab interview with my friend Kevin, who's out here from Indiana. The Claas Lexion combines you see in this video all come from Taylor Implement out of Yuma, Colorado. Taylor also sells Deutz Farr tractors and many other lines. I did do a drone flyover of their dealership before coming out to the field here, so I'll try to get that video up here on my YouTube channel in the next couple weeks. Now, let's get to harvesting some wheat.
Okay, guys, I'm doing something a little different here. As I'm out here in Colorado, I am riding with my friend Kevin from Indiana. Now, I've done some videos in the past with Kevin out here at his farm in Indiana, and I'm gonna tell you, Kevin is a combining son of a gun. I met Kevin and his son in Cutbank, Montana back in 2015. He was running a versatile combine, and I was out there to see the combines run. The trucks got full. Guy jumps out of the combine. We start talking. He said he was from Indiana, and we've been keeping in touch. And like I said, I've been to his farm a couple times, done some videos. But Kevin's got a pretty interesting story here. He is combined in a lot of states. So Kevin, you want to tell us all the places where you've run a combine besides on your farm in Indiana?
Let's see. I've been in South Dakota, Kansas, Idaho, Washington State, Montana. Where are we out here?
We're in Colorado.
Colorado.
Yeah.
Idaho.
Yeah.
So I haven't been to I need to go to Texas. Yet I haven't been there.
But Texas is hard for you because that starts early and you guys are still farming.
We're still farming.
Because you kind of, I mean, you run the sprayer at home too, so you're pretty well, once the spraying's done, then you can sneak away and then you try to be back by mid-September for your corn and soybeans at home, correct?
Well, and also, I have been to Australia and South America.
South America, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
So, okay, because their seasons are opposite of ours, right?
So I'm always looking for a new adventure.
Yep, so if you hear that, Kevin he's looking for different farms to cut on, so if you got an opportunity coming up in, you know, the Pacific Northwest, even Canada, you'd like to get up to Western Canada.
Haven't done California yet.
I mean, you wouldn't be opposed. It wouldn't necessarily have to be wheat. I mean, if you get out in some rice or something like that.
And I'll run any color.
Okay, right. And you have pretty much run every brand of combine out there, haven't you?
So I can't think of one I haven't run.
Right. So on your home farm right now, you're currently running 2-Case Internationals, correct?
Yes.
But you guys have had Deers, I know, New Hollands, and
we've had them three mostly. Right now we're in red again.
Right now you currently, the red is your favorite, right?
I think it seems to for us to do the best quality, and they're one of the easier, in my opinion. An easy combine to learn and operate.
Right, and you said you kind of got really turned on to those. You was out in Montana and run some of them.
Yeah.
And really got to like them and
thought I'd give them a try.
Yep. So yeah, good deal. How about gleaners? You ever run some gleaners?
We tried a gleaner out on our farm this last fall.
So. Okay. Yep. Okay.
And it's not a...
Right.
I've never read... They're all good machines. It's just what do you like?
Yes. I mean, you can drive by anybody's farm out there. I mean, I know the gleaners get a bad rap and stuff, but you can drive by anybody with any color combine. If it's not set right, you will see volunteer crops coming up.
Yeah,
I mean, and sometimes it's not always a combine fault, too, but they...
No, lots of times
they're
going to
be... what about a Fendt Ideal? Have you ever run one of those or demoed one of those?
Yes, I have. I ran a Fendt.
Okay, because I know you guys got some Fendt tractors on your farm.
Yeah, we got two 560s. Well, were there 1156, I think.
And I've actually videoed...
on our video.
Yep, so guys, if you've not seen those videos, I'll put the link to it at the end of this one, but... if you got some good ideas for where Kevin go run a combine next, comment or send me an email and I'll pass the information along. But he's just having a good time out here in Colorado cutting this dry land wheat, and we are in a 5,000 acre field, we heard, maybe.
Yep.
But it's not all back and forth. There's a lot of washes and a lot of things to go around, and we're out here with 12 combines, so we're gonna pop the drone up and get some more shots here.
Yep, who's ever out there, I'm always looking for a new adventure.
All right, well, thanks for taking the time to do this little in-cab interview.
You're welcome.
After I turned the camera off, we were still talking. Another adventure Kevin would like to do is he's never run a cotton picker or cotton stripper before. So if you're watching this and you're in need of a cotton harvester operator, that's another adventure. The guy's a good operator, as you can see. He's run every brand of combine out there. He's farmed his whole life. So leave a comment, or you can find my email here on my YouTube channel. Send me an email and I will put you guys in touch. And I know most of my videos are just showing the machinery. I don't do a lot of interviews like that, but I think it went pretty well. I think he had a pretty interesting story. Maybe it's something I should do more of in the future.
Oh yeah, side wiper, and you got one over here too. Hit this one. Oh, look at that.
Well, and then the front one, it used to go round and round.
Oh yeah, look at that.
No, it doesn't. Look at that. It does the...
When you weld on the cart, take it up there where we come in.
They are moving on to another field, but they're going to split up here. A couple combines are going to go to another field just a few miles from the other.
case anyone was curious about the soil here on this farm, let's have a look. Just needs water. Thank you.
that's going to do it for this video. Feel free to go down there and hit that like button, leave a comment. If you're new to my channel, I would really appreciate it if you go down there and hit that subscribe button and check back often. I'm always uploading new content to my channel here. And if you want to see more of what I'm doing, you can follow me along on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok at Farmhand Mike. As always, thank you for watching and supporting my social media.